back again. And once we are connected on Instagram, we will start the session here also. Thank you for your patience. And for today's class, you will be needing a strap, a dupatta, or a towel, or a big cloth, okay? Just to give you that deep stretches, which we are going to talk about it in a while. Okay, looks like we are having some issue on Insta, so we'll continue on Facebook here. So as I was mentioning, the main attribution for your back pain could be your incorrect posture and also weakness in the anti-gravity muscles, the muscles which hold the spine together, okay, which holds the spine upright. If they are not worked on, if they are not strong enough, then also you might experience pain and discomfort either in the lower back or also into the upper back. And also your core muscles have to be strong, because when your core is strong, it is like an armor. It's like a shield. It's like a protection. Okay. I think it's a line we will have to stop. So it is like an armor. It is like a protection, which is going to support you, give a very good support to the back. So a good strong core, a good posture, and a good strong back. This is all going to help you elevate any kind of back pain or discomfort in the back. So let us find out what is the correct posture before we get on to the yoga asanas and the correct breathing for your therapy for yoga. So when you're standing, it is very important. So most of the time when we stand, we don't realize, but we stand with the feet turned out, if you can see. I'm exaggerating the turning out of the feet just for you to understand. But most of the times when we stand, we don't realize, but we turn the feet out. When constantly and continuously we are standing with the feet turned out, it can tighten a muscle, which is the piriformis muscle, which can cause a little compression in the sciatica nerve, leading to a sciatica related pain in the lower back. Okay. And also other muscles also get compressed if you're constantly standing like this. So the correct way to stand is with all the 10 toes pointing forward. So make sure whenever you're standing, whether you're working on the kitchen, whether you're working in office or wherever you are, you stand with your feet parallel and with your toes turned forward. Okay. So that is one of the things. And then to add on to that, make sure that your ankles, your hip, your chest, your shoulder, and your ears are in a straight line. So if I turn on to the side, make sure that you're not standing like this with a slouch. See, my shoulder is not aligned with the hip anymore. So this is definitely going to cause a lot of pressure in the neck area and will lead to pain in the neck area and later maybe even cervical. So make sure that you're standing upright with your hip, your shoulder, your ear in one line. Most of the time when we are working, we don't realize we tend to jack our head forward like this. So the head, instead of resting right above the shoulders, the neck and the head is jacked forward like this. So the ear is not aligned with the shoulder. This can also cause a lot of discomfort in the neck area. Again, maybe if you're not addressing it, if you're not looking at it, over a period of time, it might also lead to cervical spondylosis. So make sure that whenever you're standing, your ear, your shoulder, your hip, and your ankles are in one line and your feet are turned in. What about the pelvis? Very, very important. Make sure if you're very bendy in the back, you're not standing like this. Because when you're standing like this, you are shortening this area, the lower back, the lumbar spine. There's a compression here, and this compression can also lead to pain and discomfort. So always focus that your tailbone, if imagine there's a tail behind, okay? And this tail is not pointing back, but this tail is pointing down. So as soon as you tuck your tailbone under, as we call it, you feel a little firmness in your abdominal muscles also. So your abdominal muscles are made to work. And when your abdominal muscles are made to work, it helps you to strengthen the core and also support your back. So make sure that your pelvis is not tilted back. We call this as an anterior tilt. So make sure your pelvis is not in an anterior tilt, okay, tilted forward, sorry. So your pelvis is not tilted forward in an anterior tilt, nor is your pelvis tilted forward in a posterior tilt. Stay in a neutral pelvis, and that is going to be very, very good for your lower back. A lot of the time we spend in seating, okay? We sit and we work for about 8 hours, 9 hours, or even 10 hours. So when you're sitting, make sure that your chair, okay, on which you're sitting and the desktop on which you're working, it's an arm distance away from each other so that you don't have to lean forward or you don't have to jack your head forward to work. So just keep your station one arm distance away. And when you're seated, make sure of the chair height. So when I'm seated right now here, very comfortably, my feet is resting on the floor, okay? I am not doing this. So don't do this. This causes a little bit of pressure in the knee and might also attribute to go into your lower back. So whenever you're sitting, try to keep your ankle and your knee in one line. Also your knee and your hip in one line. Say for example, you're a little shorter, okay? And your feet is not resting on the floor correctly. And because of which you have to fold the leg like this. It's always better to either reduce the chair height, and in case if your chair is not the adjustable kind of a chair, have something under your feet so that you can rest on it. That's important. So don't sit continuously like this, because this may lead to a lot of discomfort in the knee and then later into the back. So you can have something here, or you can always lower the chair down so that your feet are resting comfortably on the floor, wearing your ankle and your knee in one line. Also, what is a no-no is your knee going up and higher. So you're slouching back and your knee slightly lifted. So make sure your hip and your knee are in one line. Try definitely not to slouch and work. Try not to lean and work also. Have a back support like this. Have a back support which will make your spine stay upright rather than slouching, putting a lot of pressure in the lower back, or leaning forward, putting a lot of pressure in the neck. So have a back support which will sort of ensure that you keep your back straight as you're working. 1 hour of yoga, you fix your back, okay? But then you sit for 8 to 9 hours in a wrong posture. So that 1 hour of yoga where you're fixing the back is again going to not help you. So 1 hour of yoga where you correct your posture, you strengthen the muscles of the spine, of the front, of the core, and then 8 to 9 hours or throughout the day, sitting and standing in a correct posture, that is going to help you, relieve you of your back pain symptoms. Another thing before we get started on the yoga session, many a times we treat any kind of pain or discomfort locally. So I have a lower back pain, I'm going to fix my lower back, I'm going to take some medicines and all, but I'm not going to look into the rest of the body. That is also going to bring that back pain again and again. It's going to bring it back again and again. So you've got a lower back pain, you have done your physiotherapy, you have taken the required medication, you have looked into strengthening, but then again, after 3 months, 4 months, or maybe 6 months, there is a recurring back pain. That happens because we are treating the back pain only looking at it locally. The body is like a chain. Everything is interconnected. Maybe the lower back pain is not because of any kind of dysfunctioning around this particular area, but it is around the hips. A lot of muscles are connected from the spine all the way into the femur bone. These muscles, if they are tight, if they are not stretched on a regular basis, can also attribute to some kind of pull or compression, which can compress the lower back and also give you back pain. So in today's session, we are going to look into how to release the hip area, how to strengthen the back, how to strengthen the core, and how to help you to get out of your back pain and the back discomfort. And as I mentioned, you will need a strap, a towel, or a rope for today's class. So if you don't have it, please get it. Those of you watching this video later, you can pause the video and you can get it. Now I'm going to invite Pranita to take over and lead you into a very beautiful, very, very therapeutic, very, very restorative back pain session, which is going to give you good relief from your back discomfort and back pain. Stay tuned. And after this session, remember, we also have our mental health talk, which is at 11:30. So do tune in and do take a lot of inputs on how to look into the mental health. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful practice. Over to you, Pranita, now.
Good morning, all of you. Thank you, Pratibha. Welcome to today's session. Today, like Pratibha already said, we are going to do a session on yoga for back pain. So this session is going to really understand how to work on the back posture and also the postures of yoga to help to relieve from the back pain. So let's get started without any delay. Like Pratibha said, we'll be needing a strap or a towel if you have any. Keep it aside. And stretch your legs forward and start lying down onto your back on your mat. Keep your eyes closed here. Palms can be on your belly. shoulders are relaxed, toes are slightly towards your side. Make sure your head is relaxed and your neck is not having any tension. Eyes are softly closed, do not put any pressure on your eyelids and relax your facial muscles. Let us start the session with a deep abdominal breathing here. All we have to do is take a long deep inhalation together with me. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Now observe how your belly is expanding like a balloon when you inhale and when your belly is contracting when you are exhaling. So concentrate on your belly movements and start taking long deep inhalations for 4 more times. Inhale together. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale for 2 more times together. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. And exhale it now. Now observe your breathing pattern. Just take a breath or two here. And then slowly open your eyes. Now observe your body posture, the back posture. Notice if there's any gap between your lower back, upper back, mid back and the mat here. Try to reduce this gap between the back and your mat by tucking your tailbone in and engaging the core. That can happen, that can be done with the knees bended also. So try to reduce this arch and the gap between the mat and your back by tucking the tailbone in and pulling the belly in. So this is nothing but engaging the core slightly. Now, just bring your right leg over onto your left knee, right ankle over onto the left knee, and start lifting your left leg up towards the ceiling. Stay here, breathe. Try to bring your right hand inside between right leg and the left leg. Left hand comes outside of your left thigh. Interlock your fingers and just hold on to your thigh muscles, left thigh muscles here, and try to bring your leg closer and closer to your belly. When you do this, the back is nicely pressing onto the mat and you feel that massaging feeling with your back here. So try to bring your leg closer to the mat, closer to your chest, and you can keep your knee bended also. You'll start noticing slight stretch in your right hip, and which is totally fine. This is nothing but a thread the needle posture. Try to pull the knee closer towards your chest and relax for a second. We'll do it for a couple of times. You can hold on to your left shin bone also if you are in a flexible. If you find it difficult, just hold on to your thigh muscle. Again, inhale. Exhale, bring your knee closer. Lift your head up if you're not having any neck issues. And exhale, release your head down and take your knee slightly back. Again, inhale, pull your left knee closer towards your chest. Exhale, bring it back. We'll do it for 3 more times. Inhale, bring your knee closer towards your chest, pressing your back more down onto the mat. And exhale, take it away. Last 2 times. Inhale, bring your knee closer towards your chest, lift your head up without any neck issue. And exhale, take it back. Last time, we'll bring it closer and hold it for a couple of breaths. So bring your knee really closer towards your chest, left knee closer to your chest, right knee is moving away. Major lift and hold for 5. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Slowly release and relax for a second. We're going to repeat the same thing on the other side. Again, keep checking if there's an arch in your back in the mat. Try to reduce it by engaging the core and bring your left ankle onto your right knee. The left hand goes in between your both the thighs. Right hand comes outside as you're turning around so that you can understand more better. Hugging the right knee with both the palms. Pull the knee closer towards the chest. Inhale. Exhale. Bring your nose towards your knee. Away. Inhale. Exhale. Exhale, bring it closer. Inhale, take it back. Again, three. And send it away. Last two times, four. And send it away. One last time, you bring it closer and hold it there, guys. For five, four, three, two, and one. Slowly release and relax. Now, taking the strap or towel that I asked you to have, please take the strap now. Keep your knees bended. Wrap the strap around the right balls of the feet here and hold it with your right thumb as closer as you can, depending on the flexibility. Keep the right leg as straight as you can. You can also use the left hand to hold it and start pulling the leg closer towards your chest and keep pressing your upper body, lower back and mid back completely onto the ground. Again, you'll feel that your complete back is pressing onto the mat and getting little massage here. Let us see here for 10, 9, Supta Padangusthasana, very 8, 7, 6, 5, keep breathing in and out, 4, 3, breathing is a very important part of the yoga, so do not forget to concentrate on your breathing pattern by doing the posture. Last 2, and 1. Slowly release your right leg down. Let us repeat the same thing on the other side. Wrap the strap around your left balls of the feet. You can stretch your right leg forward if you are comfortable. If not, you can keep it bending. Now walk your left hand really forward. Bring your leg closer towards your upper body as much as you can, depending on your hamstring flexibility. But try not to bend your knee and keep it straight. Again, feel that your back completely pressing onto the mat and keep bringing your toes closer and hold it here. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, keep breathing all of you, and 1. Now slowly release the strap, take a second. We have two more postures in this sequence only. Take a second here for 3, 2, and 1. Now wrap the strap again around the right balls of the feet. This time you're going to take the right leg towards the right side, but do not drop it down onto the mat and make sure your left hip is not lifted off the ground. Your hips are square, left hip is pressing onto the mat. Take your right leg towards your right side closer to the ground and fold. For 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Come back to your center. Now you're going to take the right leg towards the left side completely perpendicular to the body. I'll show you by turning around. So you have to stretch the left leg, taking the right leg towards the left side. Now turn your right head towards your right side. Try not to lift your right shoulder off the mat and take this nice deep spinal twist with the body. Stay here for last 5. 4, listen to your body. Go how much ever deeper you are comfortable with. 3, 2, and 1. Come back to your center. Bring the leg back to your center. Release your leg down. We're going to repeat the same two postures on the left side also. So wrap the strap around your left balls of the feet. Hold it with your left hand and take it towards your left side. Again, make sure your right hip is pressing down onto the mat. Hold it here for 5, 4, again concentrate on your breath, 3, 2, and 1. Come back to your center. Now start taking the left leg towards your right side, all of you, and place it down onto the mat. The left leg will be stretched, left hand will be stretched to the left side, and turn the head towards your left side. A good deep spinal twist here. So 5, 4, 2, and 1. Come back to your center. Drop your leg all the way down. Now release the straps to the side. Hug the knees into the chest. Hug it really tight for 3, 2, and 1. Now place your palms over the knees. Start making small little circles with your knees here. Inwards and outwards, whichever way you are comfortable with. Last 3, 2, and 1. Now reverse it. 3, 2, and 1. Hug your knees into your chest. Roll on your back for a couple of times for 3, 2, and 1. Come up into your seating comfortable position. Press your palms down. Okay, first we'll start with seating comfortable posture here. Cross your feet, sit down in your Sukhasana. Take both the hands to the sides. Inhale, lift the right hand up towards the ceiling. Start walking your left hand towards the left side and take a lateral stretch to the left side. A small little stretch in your left right side of the body. Hold it here for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Center. And lift your left hand up towards the ceiling. Take it towards your right side. And feel a stretch happening in your complete left side of the body. For 5. 4, again, if you have too much of back pain or discomfort in the back, do not go deeper, just stay halfway. 3, 2, and 1. Come back to your center. Let us do this for 2 more times. Lift your right hand towards your left side. Come back to your center. Lift your left hand towards your right side. Come back to your center. 1 last time, right hand to the left side. Come back to your center. Left hand to your right side. Come back to your center. Let us take 1 or 2 spinal twists here. So take both the hands to the sides. Lift both the hands up. Inhale. Exhale, bring your right hand onto your left knee. Twist back. Look over your left shoulder. Do not release your upper body this way. Keep it tall and straight. Look over your left side and hold for 5. Small engagement in your core. 4, and a good stretch in your back. 3, 2, 1. Inhale, come back to the center, lift your hands up. Exhale, left hand towards your onto your right knee. Look over your right shoulder and hold. Keep your back tall and straight. For 3, 2, and 1. Come back to your center. Now stretching the palms all the way down. Come up into your all 4. Nice. Palms are right under your shoulders here. Knees are right under the hips. This is called all 4 position. We're going to do a few cat-cow stretches. Cat-cow stretches are very basic and very good postures for the back. All we do is we're going to inhale, arch the back, drop the belly down. Dropping the belly as if it's trying to reach towards the mat and lift the gaze up towards the ceiling. Now exhale, round and squeeze your belly in. Pull your belly inside, chin towards the chest. 2 more times. Inhale, arch. Exhale, round. Inhale, arch. Try to really bring your belly towards your mat. Look up. Now exhale, round, pull your navel into your spine completely, keep pushing your float away, round your spine and bring your chin towards your chest. Now we'll hold the cat-cow stretch. Inhale, arch and hold. Look up, hold. 5, 4, 3, 2, shoulders away from the ears, and 1. Now round and squeeze your belly and pulling your belly completely towards your spine. Chin knees into your chest. Keep pushing your float away for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Slowly come back to your center. Now we are going to do a cat-cow stretch variation. Same way, but a little different. Observe. Coming into the cat-cow, all fours again, I'm going to lift my right leg off the mat. Keep it in parallel towards your hip or just slightly above, however you're comfortable. Now release your left hand all the way forward and hold. You'll have to engage your core slightly to reduce that arch in your spine. Try to keep your back neutral here. Let us lift up and hold. Try to look at one non-moving point. If not, you lose the balance. Just look up onto your ground or mat, onto one non-moving point here. Last five. Very good. Four, three, two, and one. Come back to your center. We'll repeat the same thing on the other side. We're going to inhale, lift the left leg up, slightly above your hip level if you can. And take your right hand all the way forward. Reduce that arch in your spine. Four, five. Four, three, two, and one. Come back to your center and take a second. Lay down onto your knees. Take a second. Breathe in and breathe out for three, two, and now. So like we discussed, back pain can also happen because of a little tightness in the hip area. Now we'll do two postures that will stretch your hip muscles and are good for the hip openers. Coming up into your all fours, let us bring the right leg between your palms. So if you are somewhere here and not really flexible with your hips or hamstrings, use your right hand support to really drag your right leg really forward. Make sure your right foot, both the palms are in one straight line. If your left knee is hurting, put a cushion or a towel under your left knee. So both the palms are on either side of your right foot. Lift your chest up, look forward, keep sinking your hips down. You'll start feeling that nice stretch in your hips and your psoas muscles. Enjoying the stretch will speed off of each round. Now those who are comfortable and ready to take it to a little intense level, release your hands towards the ceiling and hold for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, don't forget to breathe, 2, and 1. Slowly bring your palms down on either side of your right foot. Now the second posture is nothing but a lizard posture. Bring your right hand inside of your right foot and walk your right leg slightly out. Left leg is again still back, do not change it. Now either stay here, look up towards your front or towards the ceiling by sinking your hips down. If you want to take it more deeper, just drop your elbows down onto the mat and hold. Stay there for 10 counts, all of you. If you feel a little stretch in your hips and you're unable to stay here, just take a stretch back and come back into the posture once again. So stay here for 10, a very good hip opener, guys, a basic one also. 9, 8, 7, you can turn your toes slightly out. 6, and make sure your knees in line with your toes. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Slowly walk your hands back and take your right leg all the way back. Sit down either on your knees or you can take a gentle child's posture or a balasana, a very relaxation posture in yoga. Stay here for 3, all of you. 2, and 1. Now again, stretch your palms down. We want to repeat both the postures on the other side. Coming into your all fours, bring your left leg between your palms. Now again, if you're halfway or if you're not completely towards the top of the mat, use your left hand and take your left leg really forward. Both the palms are on either side of your left foot. Sink your hips down, look forward. Stay here for 5. If you want to take it a little bit more intense, just bring your palms onto your left knee, lift your both the hands towards the ceiling. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Drop both the palms down. Just bring your left hand inside of your left foot. Sink your hips down. If you feel a little strain in your muscles or something, you want to relax, just take your leg back for a second and again come back. Again, look forward into your lizard. If you're comfortable, stay. If you want to go a little deeper, you can always choose to drop your elbows onto the mat. Listen to your body, act accordingly, and don't forget to breathe. Let's stay here for last 8. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Press your palms down, take your hips slightly back. Take your left leg back onto your mat and relax down into your child's pose too. Stay here for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now stretch your palms down, tuck your toes and lift your hips up into a gentle downward facing dog or parvatasana. But make sure you're bending your knees slightly and hold. In anyone with a back issue, always avoid to keep your legs straight. In most of the postures, we are supposed to keep our knees bending because that's really good for the back. So stay in your downward facing dog for 5 with your knees bended. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Look to the top of the mat, just bring your right leg a little forward and come up. So when you do this, you automatically come up into this kind of stance where the right toes are pointing forward, left toes are slightly inside. And make sure both the heels are in one straight line. Now let us stretch both the hands to the sides, pull your core in. If your tailbone is outside, try to tuck it inside. Engage your core slightly in. Now let's inhale, reach your upper body forward. Exhale, drop your right hand really down, either onto your right foot or you can go all the way down. Now look up towards the ceiling at your left hand fingertips and stay. Again, don't forget to breathe for 10, 9, 8, 7. Feel a stretch happening in your right hamstring and the left side of the body. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now to come up, you can bend your right knee slightly. Inhale, come up. Exhale, relax. So this is Trikonasana, triangle posture. We are going to repeat the same thing on the other side. Turn your right toes inside, left toes outward. Try to keep both the heels in one straight line. Extend both the hands towards your side. Reach forward. Drop your left hand down. Lift your right hand up. Look towards your right hand, right fingertips. Keep your chest turned up. So we have a tendency to do this, to drop your right shoulder down. Try to avoid it and turn your right shoulder really back and lift your right hand up. Hold for 8, 7, don't forget to breathe. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. To come up, you can bend your left knee slightly, lift yourself up, and turn your toe. Take a second here. You can just move your legs if you have to. Just stay here for 3, 2, and 1. Now drop both the palms onto the mat. Take your right leg back and sit up onto your feet again. We are going to first do 2 seating postures. Cross your feet and sit down. Stretch your legs all the way forward and turn around. Bend your right knee. Bring it outside of your left thigh. Hug it with your left hand and look over your right shoulder. A very good spinal twist again in your seating. Good for the back. Make sure your left leg is highly active and pull your left toes closer towards your head. So look back and breathe here. Try to keep your back nice and straight. 5. Long in deep inhalations. 4. 3. With every inhalation, try to lift your chest up. With every exhalation, try to turn your right shoulder a little bit more back. Last 3. 2 and 1. Slowly come back to your center, straight in your right leg. Let us repeat the same thing on the other side. Bend your left knee and bring it outside of your right thigh. Hug it with your right elbow. Take your left hand behind your spine and look over your left shoulder. Keep your spine nice and tall. Don't forget to breathe. Work with your breath always. 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Come back to your center, stretch your left leg all the way forward. Now we are going to do a Paschimottanasana. So whenever we have any back issues or any sprain in the back muscle, it's advised to keep your knees bended when you're going into a forward fold of Paschimottanasana. Slightly bend it here. Inhale, lift your hands up. Imagine someone is pulling ourselves towards the ceiling here. While exhaling, reach forward with your knees slightly bended. If you're able to hold on to your toes, go ahead and hold your toes. If you're just reaching to your calf muscles or your ankles, feel free to do that. Wherever you are, keep moving slightly forward. Listen to your body. Do not strain yourself too much. And look at your big toes. Stay here for 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Inhale, slowly lift up. Exhale, release your palms down. Now let us lie down onto our belly and do a few back strengthening postures. So it's always back pain can be because of the back posture, lack of back flexibility, or lack of back strength also. Now let us try and strengthen the back muscles by lying down onto the belly. So press your palms down, take your legs back, lie down onto your belly here. You can keep your hands palms one over the other and drop your chin onto your both the palms. All we're going to do is lift the right leg up, inhale, and bring it down. So while doing that, we have a tendency to take the right hip a little back this way, turning it outside. Let us try not to do that. Press both the hip bones onto the mat and lift your right leg up towards the ceiling and bring it down. Let us do it for 10 times, all of us together. 1, down. 2, down. 3, down. 4, down. 5, down. 6, down. 7, down. 8, down. Last two times. 9, down. Let us lift the right leg up this time and hold it there. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. You might start feeling a little work happening in your lower back. That's totally fine. That is where we are trying to work on. Take a second. Now we'll do the same thing on the left side also. Let's go. 1, down. 2, down. 3, down. 4, down, inhale, 5, exhale, down, 6, down, 7, down, 8, down, 9, down, last one, will lift and hold it there, as high as you can, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax for a second. Take a second, breathe. Those who are having a little weakness in the lower back might already feel a work in the lower back, and it can be too much already. So just listen to your body, do how much ever you can, and take some rest. So that was for the lower back. Now we are going to work on the upper back. Bring both the palms under your shoulder. place it under the shoulders here. Make sure the toes are completely pressing onto the mat. We're going to inhale, lift the hands and chest off the mat. Observe once, one, and down. So while doing this, we are going to inhale, lift up, and while bringing down, exhale, go down. Let's do it for 10 times. Inhale, one, and down. Always look down, do not look forward. It might strain your neck muscles. Two, and down. Three, and down. Strengthening the upper back muscles. Four, and down. Five, and down. Six, and down. Seven, and up. Eight, down. Nine, down. Last one, 10, and hold it there. One, two, three, don't forget to breathe and do not hold your breath at all. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Relax and take a second. Just breathe in and breathe out for a second. Three, two, and one. So with any low back or upper back issues, you can include this in your workout. For at least 2 to 3 sets is also fine. But if you're a beginner, do start with one set of 10 repetitions. Now again, bring your palms under the shoulders. We are going to inhale into your Bhujangasana. Lift your chest up, shoulders away from the ears. Keep your elbows bended and hug them towards your sides. Exhale, go all the way down. Inhale, lift your chest up. Exhale, go all the way down. We'll do it only for 2 last time. Inhale, lift it up. Listen to your body, please. Exhale, go all the way down. Last time, inhale, lift it up. Exhale, go all the way down. Again, relax here for a second. Breathe in and breathe out for 3. 2. And 1. Now, just you can roll onto your back. So lie down on your back. Yeah, coming down onto your back here on a supine posture. Just stretch both the legs towards your front. We're going to do 3 to 4 postures on lying down, again increasing the back strengthening, also a bit of flexibility here. Take both the hands beside your sides towards your in a T shape, left hand to the left side, right hand to the right side. If you don't have enough space, you can take a cactus like me. Elbows in line with your arms and palms in line with your elbows. It's like a cactus posture. Now from here, we are going to bring both the knees towards your chest. All we are going to do is, with the core strength and with the back strength a little, we're going to drop both the knees towards the right side and again come back to your center. To your right side and again come back to your center. Do it with lot of core strength and your back strength here. If at all you feel it's too much, just go halfway and come back. Be very careful while doing this. First, let us start with the right all of us together. So hands in your cactus or a T shape. Let's glue both the knees towards each other. Start dropping both the knees towards your right side. You can keep your left head towards your left side. Come back to your center. Inhale here. Exhale, take both the knees towards your right side. And bring the knees back to the center. 3. And come back to your center. We'll do it for 8 times. 4. Be very gentle. And come back to your center. 5. And come back to your center. 6. And come back to your center. Last 2 times. 7. Come back to your center. Last one. 8. Will drop the knees down and stay there for a couple of breaths. So drop both the knees towards your right side. Turn your head towards your left side. And stay in this nice deep spinal twist for a couple of breaths. For 5. 4. Make sure both the knees are pressing into each other. three, two, and one. Again, slowly come back to your center. Drop your legs down, take a second. Notice if you're feeling anything in your back. Any sides, of course. For three, two, and one. We'll repeat the same thing on the other side. Stretch both the hands to the sides in a T shape or a cactus. Knees towards your chest. Drop them towards your left side. And bring it back. Two. And bring it back. Do it very slowly, guys. Three. And bring it back. Four. And bring it back. Five. And bring it back. Six. And bring it back. Seven. Center. Last one, will go to the left side and hold it there. Turn your head towards your right side and breathe. For eight. The important thing is to keep touching your right shoulder onto the mat. Seven. Six. Five. Four. Three. Two. And one. Come back to your center. Bring your legs back to the center and release your heels onto the mat. Take a second here. Observe your back muscles. Observe your complete body. Notice where you're feeling that stretch and strength. Breathe in and breathe out for five. Four. Three. Two. And one. Now press your both the heels onto the mat. Hands beside your glutes. You're going to inhale, lift the hips up towards the ceiling, engaging the glutes here, bringing the chest towards your chin and hold. This is nothing but a bridge posture or a Setu Bandhasana. You're going to hold this posture for 10 counts. 10, squeeze your thighs and the glutes together. Very good posture for the back muscles again. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Slowly release your hips down. Now we are going to do it dynamically for 10 times. All we do is we inhale, lift both the hands up together with the hips up. Exhale, bring your hands down or hips down. Or you can just choose to press your palms down and lift the hips also, which is totally fine. Let's do it for 10 times. Inhale, lift your hips up. Exhale, go down with your breath. Do it with your breath, please. Inhale, lift your hips up. Exhale, bring your hips up. Third one. Inhale, lift your hips up. Exhale, bring your hips down. We're going to do it for 7 more times. Inhale, lift your hips up. Do it very gently. Exhale, bring it down. Five. And bring it down. Six. Down. Seven. Down. Eight. Inhale. Exhale down. Last two times. Nine. Exhale down. Last one. Inhale. Lift your hips up. Exhale. Lift your hips. Very good. Take a second here. Just breathe in and breathe out for five. Again, observe your back muscles. Just breathe into your back muscles for a couple of breaths. Four. Three. Two. And one. Now we are going to do one more spinal twist. Last second posture. Stretch both the legs to the front. Lift your right leg up to the ceiling. Both the hands are supposed to be in a T shape. Or if you're having any space crunch, you can just keep it bended into your cactus. Now lift your right leg up. Either drop it towards your left side completely onto the mat horizontally. Or if you find it difficult, you can just keep your knee bended and drop it down. Take a nice deep spinal twist. Turn your head towards your right side and stay here for 5 counts, guys. Just breathe into your spine and back here. 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Come back to your center, lift your right leg up and release it down. Repeat the same thing on the other side. Lift your right leg up, either drop it horizontally down or keep your knee bended. Press your left shoulder onto the mat and turn towards your left side. Take this nice deep spinal twist, hold it here for 5. Again, listen to your body, go how much ever deep you are comfortable, do not push yourself too much. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Come back to your center, release and take a second here. Now, last one, last posture, but a very good for the back here. A one go-to posture whenever you're having a little back pain or tired with your back muscles is Viparita Karni, legs against the wall. So I'm going to take my legs against the wall and show you how the posture is. All we have to do is bring your hips closer to the wall first and start lying down onto the back in such a way that your legs are against the wall this way. Make sure your hips are pressing into the wall and back of your legs are also completely relaxed onto the wall. Bring your toes closer towards your forehead facing them and palms can be towards your sides. You can keep your eyes closed and lie down in this position for a couple of breaths and see. It's like a gentle inversion also where there's blood reversal happening because the legs are towards the ceiling and the upper body is onto the mat. Stay here for a couple of breaths and again concentrate on your abdominal breathing. Just observe your belly movements, breathing pattern for a couple of breaths here. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, 3, 2, and 1. Bend your knees. Slowly turn towards your left side and lie down on your back into your Shavasana. We'll do a small pranayama after this. So stay tuned. Lie down on your back. Feet are more than hip width apart. Hands are away from the body. Relax your neck muscles. Relax your shoulders and lie down into your short Shavasana here. Keep your eyes closed. Do not take body weight in any body part. Try to relax the complete body onto the mat. Notice if any body part is stiffened, try to consciously relax it down. And try to consciously send your breath into every single muscle, into every single body part, into every single cell here. Try to observe it mentally. Try to observe from the top of the mat, the top of the head, crown of the head to the toes of the feet. Try to observe mentally. And send some long, deep inhalations consciously into them. Staying here for a couple of more breaths. Now with this exhalation, very simply bringing the attention back to your physical body, move your toes, move your palms, move your head gently side to side. Take your hands above your head, interlock your fingers, give a gentle stretch to your complete body. Release. Bend your knees, turn towards your right side. Stay here for a breath or two. Whenever you're comfortable, press your palms down and sit up into any seating comfortable posture. So we're going to do some pranayama here. Keep your eyes closed, back straight. We'll do 5 rounds of Anulom Vilom or Nadi Shodhana. Keep your back straight, both the palms in your chin mudra to start with. Just follow my instructions and let us do it together. Roll your shoulders away from your ears, keep your eyes closed. Let us take two normal inhalations with both the nostrils. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Now bring your right hand in your Nashika Mudra. Close your first two fingers, index and the middle finger. All the other fingers are open here. Now controlling the right nostril with the thumb finger, close the right nostril. Exhale out completely from your left nostril. Inhale from your left nostril, long and deep. Exhale from your right nostril, long and deep. Inhale from your right nostril, long and deep. Exhale from your left nostril, long and deep. Inhale two. Exhale right. Inhale right. Exhale left. Inhale left. Exhale right. Inhale right. Exhale left. One last time. Inhale left. Exhale right. Inhale right and exhale left. Release your palms down. Observe the sensations of your body. Observe if there is any difference between the practice and after the practice. Observe your complete physical and mental state. Holding on to these sensations and feelings, let us bring the palms to the heart center. Rub the palms gently from deep here and place it over the eyes, face, and open your eyes and look at your palms. Thank you, all of you. Thank you for joining me. I hope you liked the session. Do practice these postures and the pranayama. And do let us know. Take care, all of you. See you again. Don't forget to attend all other events of Ananta Yoga and Yoga Month. Thank you. Take care. Hope to see you soon. Bye.